Welcome to Friday, July 10th, 2020. Stagnant summer weather is going to lead to a summer sizzle through the weekend. Although I don't see many records getting broken, there might be a couple. It's just going to be a hot summer weekend as high pressure remains over the Rockies and the High Plains through the weekend. There'll be a little bit of a change in the pattern next week, but through the weekend, it's going to be very hot. Fire dangers are sky high. They have really gone up this week in many areas. There are a lot of fire restrictions, especially in the forest, but across the plains as well. Be really, really careful this weekend. Now, we still see that monsoon starting late next week and beyond. It's going to be a very weak monsoon this year. Keep your expectations in check, but we do expect thunderstorm chances to get better mid to late week in the region. We'll give you another update on Comet NEOWISE. Now, the fire danger map looks like this for today. Look at all the orange and the red across the Intermountain West. You know, this is where we really have to be concerned about anything getting started here soon till we can get those more moist thunderstorms that come in. This is going to be a critical weekend to get through with extremely high fire dangers in the very high to extreme category over most of Colorado and Wyoming's mountain areas. Only the Pacific Northwest, parts of Yellowstone National Park, in moderate fire danger conditions, while the rest of the West is getting more and more dry. This is why it's been so dry. This big dome of high pressure placed right over Arizona and New Mexico continues to bring desert heat into the area. And also, this is just not a good way to get subtropical moisture into this part of the world to get those thunderstorms going, at least to get them to be there where they're rain producers. We've had over the last couple of days some decent rain-producing thunderstorms here that then have moved off like this, but have avoided really giving any front range areas or the mountain areas any needed rain. This is the rainfall forecast through Sunday afternoon. Notice up here where it's been raining more. They'll continue to see shower and thunderstorm activity in this area here. These showers and thunderstorms mainly come Sunday afternoon and evening as some of that moisture work its way on up. But you can see that along and west of the divide, you just don't have much. And these are the type of thunderstorms that you don't want because they're the type of thunderstorms that give you the dry lightning that can a lot of times be fire starters around here. Now, by Tuesday, notice the high pressure ridge shifts east, but also flattens out a bit. We have actually a Pacific cool front that's going to make early next week a little cooler. This will be especially true by Tuesday. But the shift in the weather will also allow this high to move more to the east. And that happens by late next week. By Thursday, the high pressure center leaves Arizona and New Mexico and heads east. And as we've been talking about, that opens the door to that subtropical moisture. So late next week, better chances for showers and thunderstorms move in. This shows you how dry the air is right now in the region. Look at all this dryness across the Intermountain West and the Pacific Northwest. You're just not going to get any thunderstorms. This is why that moisture, see this moisture sitting up here? This will continue to cause an active area of thunderstorms through the weekend, but not in the Rockies and adjacent plains. Further out, though, this is by next Friday, the dryness shrinks. We have white and green. White means average, and the green picks up. So this will lead to some better chances for showers and thunderstorms here by late next week and next weekend. Now, I want to give you an update on Comet NEOWISE. I was actually able to see it for the first time this morning. Finally, he didn't have any obstructions. And it's a really neat sight. Really recommend you have binoculars, but you can see it. Let your eyes adjust. And if you can get into a dark situation outside of the city, you can see it without binoculars. You just need to know where to look. But in binoculars and a telescope, it's pretty impressive. You really do need to be up early. I was able to see it around 4:45 this morning. Once you get past 5 o'clock, we have two things going on. You have the sun rising and you see it kind of get washed out. We also have a pretty bright moon out there still. Now the moon is going into its phases where it will be less and less moon, but get up early. Starting Monday though, for those of you that don't want to get up early, it's going to start showing up in the evenings and will be around in the evenings all month into early August, but it will be fading in intensity in terms of brightness the further we go on. We'll show you some maps here in a moment. Go to spaceweather.com for more details. Lots of images posted this morning from around the globe really good shot out of Cody, Wyoming earlier this morning. Now, this is where we're going to be Saturday morning. Again, right around between 4:30 and 5 a.m. is where you want to look to the east, northeast. Again, find Capella. That's a pretty bright star that you can see even as the sun comes up. If you follow it down a little to the left, you're going to find it. And that's Saturday morning. Sunday morning, notice the comet's moving. It's moving a little bit more to the east, northeast now for Sunday morning, but essentially it's going to be in the same area. Then as we work our way into Monday, we now are looking to the northwest, but now after sunset. After sunset, find the Big Dipper, the end of the Big Dipper, then go due down from there, looking off at a heading of 330 degrees, so basically off to the northwest. And this is where the comet's going to be for quite a while, in the northwestern evening skies, again, low to the horizon, but easily visible, especially with binoculars and a telescope. Have a great weekend, everybody. We'll talk.